Ah! Ah-ha-ha! Okay, there we go. Why video games? Okay. So, we are playing this with the version 1.2.8 fan patch. I am, as of the time of this recording, which is July 6th, we are on the most recent version of this patch. You can see when the last update was up here at the top, because the developers use insane naming senses. Time for Wizardry, yeah. So we have to start a new game, and we're doing 7-8. So we have the party here. We have to find our actual end game save, though, which I think is this guy. Okay, so we're gonna have to review the characters. We are going to have to level these guys. I don't know if I might be able to do it now, but before we do that, we're gonna have some other stuff we need to do. We're gonna have to pick like faces and change some stuff. I think you can do that by this. Yes. So swell. We have to redo the entire party. Take it easy, Hurricut. Godspeed with the dark eye. I hope it's not too terrible. So we gotta pick voices and everything. That is not swell. That's a good chunk portrait, though. Perhaps Devon. So this game actually has what I would consider... Jesus. I think this has some new portraits and stuff in it. I don't think they move, though, like the ones in the base game. But I don't know. Jesus Christ. I kind of have to. All right, that's swell. So voices.
By my honor, I swear I'll protect you from danger.
Volume is a bit low. I'll have to change that once we're in game.
Don't worry about a thing, friend. I'll take care of it for you.
The talking animation is kind of rough, yeah.
Is there something you need?
He's like jaw coming unhinged.
Just don't put it in writing.
Well, hello there. I think I...
That is not a swell.
Who can make the muddy water clear? Let the water be still and it will become clear on its own.
No. I think we're actually going to go with this one. This seems pretty paladin-y. Is this what we want? Done. All right, swell. Ela! We can finally give him his full name. I think it'll actually let me use it for his nickname too, like for screen display. Do we have more portraits for the cats? Oh my god, we've got furries. Okay, Ela. Ela, are you monk cat? Sagely cat, obvious samurai cat, or dapper cat? You gotta let me know, buddy. Samurai pizza cat? Okay, samurai pizza cat. You need cunning?
Is there something you need? I do it. Just don't put it in writing.
Okay.
Just between you and me, I'm the perfect guy for this job. What do you say?
So you're gonna be Italian cunning, or...
Is there something you need?
Or Italian cunning?
Just don't put it in a right.
Voice 2? Alright, voice 2. I got you. Alright, and that's Ela. And so the downside to this is that compared to the first game, we bring in like next to none of our cool items. We basically don't bring in anything nifty. And it makes me sad. Wow, this is literally the only ninja portrait. Okay.
All right, but don't expect me to waste my time yakking.
No.
Sure. I'm itching to do something wild and reckless anyway.
No, that's going to be Sin's voice, though.
Tis wit, not strength, that make a solid lad. But I be lucky to have both.
That's Chunk. The voice sounded so dead. Foil! Oh god, man! Jesus Christ. So do we have any angry... I might have to make Sin the Cossack. Cause there's no other real. Guess maybe this one.
Sure. I'm itching to do something wild and reckless anyway.
Yeah, there we go. Right, Gold Leaf, which we can actually fully name Gold Leaf now. Well, that's close already. What else we got? All right, that's easy.
An adventure?
No.
Sure, darling.
Good God, no.
One may feel fear in the face of danger, so...
No.
Well, well. I wondered when you would get around to me. You won't be disappointed.
Okay, that's leaning towards it. What else do we have?
Just relax.
Nope.
Release your hold on this world.
That's all dark. Nah, we'll go with...
One may feel fear in the face...
He goes this one?
Well, well.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. Rove. Rove could be fun. What kind of evil, crazy... Oh! That was fast. Okay.
Ordinary men fear the power of darkness. I revel in it.
Wow, Rove was easy. Holy shit. Okay. So we do this. And now it's going to give us the cutscene, and ideally it will be properly full screen. Oh, we have difficulty level. I think you can change these whenever you want. We are going to be played with simplified NPC interaction because I don't want to deal with a text parser. And good Christ, we're not playing an Iron Man game.
You've lost track of the time.
Oh, you guys can't even. Oh, there goes.
Stepped on board the ship. Now, at last, your long pursuit of the Dark Savant is about to end.
I've located the Savant's ship. It's orbiting the planet Dominus. I only hope we can get there in time.
You think back to how it all started. The events on Guardia are a distant memory.
Yeah, they are.
Now it's about to begin again. Vi Domina, your constant companion, paces back and forth, her expression flashing between anticipation and dark doubt. As you begin your descent, your craft comes under the baleful watch of the Dark Savant and his black ship.
Master, we have detected a ship about to land on the planet's surface.
I arrived too late to stop the others, but these intruders will never enter the circle!
What should I do?
Destroy them!
The shock of the attack throws you to the deck. For a time, all is dark.
Stock sound effects.
Your senses return. You have washed up on a beach among the rest of the crash debris. It's a miracle that you're still alive, but your biggest challenge is still ahead of you. Your ship is gone. You're stranded on a strange world, and somewhere far above, the Dark Savant awaits. You turn toward shore and plan your next move.
Yeah, I fucking love the campiness of this. It's great. All right. This is Vi.
This is the monastery. I can't believe it. It's so good to be back on Dominus. I thought I'd never make it home after the Dark Savant yanked me out of here. While you check things out here, I'm going to Arnica to make sure everything's okay there. We'll meet up in a couple of days, okay?
Okay.
Be careful, guys. The Dark Savant could be anywhere.
Yeah, he's like hiding out with those crabs over there. Okay, so we do
it's
have mouse look.
To be recognized.
I have changed hotkeys to give us WASD movement. Everybody is going to gain levels here. I think we bump to fifth level because we're imported characters. And the first thing I'm gonna, I do not want to quit the game. Escape being quit, terrible. First thing we're gonna do is save. We're gonna be saving this so much. Audio levels, okay. Speech is Mac. All right. I think sound is appropriate. Okay, that's the music. I don't want the music to be crazy. We might leave these fairly low. If any of it's too low, just let me know. There are subtitles for everything though, so ideally folks will be able to read along. So the fan-made patch adds two things that I am really excited for. One is this, monster movement speed. We'll play with it at the default value for a while, and you guys will, I'm sure, quickly come to realize why we're going to want to have it maxed out later in. And the other one they give us is monster animation speed. And between these two things, it makes combat a lot fucking faster, because the combat in this game drags so much ass. It's like from a bad 80s sci-fi. Yes. Yes, it is, and it's glorious. Okay, so before we do anything, let's see what we have. Oh, we have a bard instrument. So the carried inventory, I think, is that shared? No. Okay. Oh, party items are our shared inventory. Carried is what he has on him. We have here a main gosh. Apparently Swell brought over a ray gun. We'll have to see what our skills and stuff are. Okay, Ela at least kept his katana and wakizashi. Sadly, he no longer has the Masamune blade.
Add this to my personal collection.
God, it's Italian Bilbo. So we have a kabuto, which is good samurai armor. Oh my god, it let us bring over the fucking salted monk meat. But nothing else worth anything. So how do I, can I just like, there we go. So let's just do brimstone nuggets. Miscellaneous item, it gives 20% fire resistance. Sure, here you go.
Like to add this to my personal
and
collection.
This is just food. Fucking game. Gotta save the snack for the long journey. All right, Sin is still a bard. We have Angel's Tongue. Chromatic Leer, a bunch of musket balls. I don't know. It doesn't look like we brought any muskets. I'm glad he brought over a bunch of musical instruments, though. That's exciting to me. Mouse wheel scrolling. Blessed mouse wheel scrolling. You can't use this. Music 70, bard level 14. Damn, and it casts Banish. What does Banish do? I have no idea. Siren's Wail is insanity. Slow. We do have the Poet's Loot for Sleep, hell yes. Itching Skin from the Chromatic Leer, and Bless. All right, so he actually brought over some good instruments. This game actually has a lot of really good bard instruments in it. I was originally planning on having him be a gadgeteer, but you have to start as a gadgeteer if you want to come over with the their gun, which is what makes them so great, because it's basically a weapon that scales with them as they level and gets just absolutely busted by endgame. And it should be instant death for demons. Nice. I thought I had a manual for this. I even dug out my boxed copy, but apparently I don't. So I'm gonna have to go dig one up online somewhere. You can use a Midnight Cloak, which is a bonus to close combat and some extra AC. But I don't know that I'm gonna have him use it. I think I'm probably gonna have Chunk use it. So the thing with multi-classing in this game is, unlike the first game, you basically don't want to multi-class in this one. It's not, you can't like jump back and forth with multi-classing, so it went from something that was fun to tinker around with to less. All right, we got some mana stones, nice. Also more mana stones, golden apples, restore magic, nice. Bull whips that sadly casters are not proficient with anymore. They do have extended range though. I'm gonna have to learn all the class icons. Where's Bard? There, Bard? Okay. What is this? A stun rod. Okay, it's got paralysis on it. Good damage. 9 to 13. Scroll of magic missiles, sure. Okay, so what weapons? Staff of Charming got borrowed over. Nice. The auto chance to knock suckers out. Basic staff. He has a short sword, which he's not going to use because he's not front row. That's going to Swell. Chunk, you're just going to be hands and fist. So one thing this does is it has alternate weapons, so you can have a melee weapon and a ranged weapon attack equipped at the same time, which is great, and there's an option that makes it automatically swap between them as you need them. Hey, Silencer, good to see ya. You did miss the ending of Icewind Dale, yeah. We just finished it maybe 10 minutes ago or so, 15 minutes ago. Why are Chunk's legs so bendy? It's the rickets. The rickets came for him. So it looks like for now, Swell is going to actually be dual wielding. Scimitar is not going to be fighting with, well, the Mystery Ray. Does this have... I don't know if this requires ammo. I would assume that it does, but maybe it doesn't. And if not, that's what he's going to use. And that is about it. We have Emu's Paw, which I think... God, who was using this? I can't remember if it was Chunk or Ela. I think it might have been Ela using this thing in his offhand. It hexes things. Uses staff and wand. But it's cursed. 5 to 10, plus 1 to hit, plus 5 initiative. I mean, it's better than his Wakizashi. But he can't... Oh no, it's red because it's cursed. Yeah, okay. So I'm curious if you can swap between these or not. Like, can you? No. Okay, that's fine. It doesn't seem to have any real negatives to it. It's just... It curses things when you hit them. We have Amulets of Life, which require artifacts 35 to use, and these are our resurrection items. This stun rod. This thing seems really good, but the initiative penalty is rough. The back scratcher that can never be removed. Exactly. 9 to 23. This is like ridiculous. The pole arm. So I'll have him try that. I don't know. I'm gonna leave it there for now. I'm gonna save again and we're gonna do leveling. This is gonna be a slow start. I apologize because we're gonna have to go through 6 characters leveling each of them like 4 or 5 times here. So we get bonus points. And you can mouse over things and get information so we actually know what they do. I think we can only, I think you can only do so many a level. Profession skills is apparently dual weapons for Swell, the paladin. No. He can't level his magic skills yet because he's not high enough level to cast spells. Once he gets spells, he'll be able to. He does actually have pretty well-spread weapon skills, which is nice. I'm gonna give him sword, and I'm gonna give him shield. I assume your weapon skills level as you use them. And if I'm gonna have him use a pole arm, I'll just let him level the thing. Okay, and then, yeah. Level by use, yes, hell yeah. Glad to hear it. Dexterity is chance to hit and to penetrate. Very important. Close combat, sword, shield. I'll probably keep leveling shields, because if it's like the first game, they're gonna drag real bad for leveling. But once we have spells, we're gonna start investing in our spell casting stuff. Maxing out a stat to 100 gives you a special skill. Oh shit, okay, good to know. We'll get there eventually. Okay, so now he's got spells. I'm gonna grab, he has Bless and Heal Wounds because we ported him. I'm gonna grab Make Wounds just for the extra spell points, I think. Additional healing, and now you can see that we can invest in our spell skills. Which, I want to say this is like the first game where you level by using them, but as you level them more, you unlock like spell levels. What is Divinity? Affects the learning of new priest spells, and to a lesser degree than the other realms, contributes spell points to every realm. Oh shit, okay. So I'm not going to invest too heavily in these, because Swell really isn't like 1000% spellcaster. That's Goldleaf's problem. Thank you, Kibitz. Icewind Dale wasn't too bad. I was expecting it to be a little bit more work to finish it, but we got through it. Oh, Ela. What are we going to put our points in? You're going Dexterity and probably also Strength, because you are also melee fighting. And we're giving you swords, and we are giving you dual weapons. And, oh, that's interesting, you can't level some stuff. Curious. I don't need close combat. And like Swell, you'll eventually start getting stuff. I want to come out here really quick, discard changes, yes. I want to check Ela, and I want to see what this thing is. Staff and Wand, okay. Because they're not innate class skills. Ah, okay, that makes sense. He can level Staff and Wand, though. Okay. Oh, shit. Ela, did you want me to go hard in on your critical strike so you can be, like, insta-giving the shit out of things? Or do you want me to just kind of throw points wherever? Wherever? All right. We'll give you close combat, and I'll just kind of alternate his extra points between dual weapons and critical strikes. Do you want to actually hit? Yeah, that's exactly it. But in the last game, Ela was doing both, and he was scary. By the end of 7, he was a fucking blender. He had so many attacks every round. It was insane. And just insta-kills everywhere. I think Ela killed the Dark Savant in the last game, if I recall correctly. It was just down. It was down to Ela and the Dark Savant, and that was it, and he fucking kicked the shit out of him. Samurai, like, yeah, that's what I would expect. So I don't know. You have sleep, you have energy blast, we'll grab light. Because I know that Wago will eventually be on the menu. Yes, you are in fact a murder kitty, and Chunk was basically just fisting. Wow, one bonus point. Ouch. Sorry, Chunk. Okay, critical strike, close combat. Oh, it's martial arts now, okay. And eventually you need to start putting points into his trap stuff as well. His stats are so average. The stats in this game are very different from how they were in the older games. In the older games, they, like, an 18 or a 20 was really high. This goes all the way to 100. So the scaling is different. But yeah, most people's stats are pretty middle of the road. But for now, I just want to get my front row to the point where they fight good and can reliably hit things. And then later on, casters get really, really powerful. AoE spells with how encounter sizes scale as you get further into this game, AoE spells become just invaluable. We'll give Chunk healing as well. I suppose it can't hurt. Start with a Dwarven Ninja character creation, you get negative points, so you need to take a few levels to get before you get to invest stat points. Ah! That makes sense. Played Rollmaster, so you know stats 1 to 100, hopefully this is more balanced. Yeah, we'll see. Alright, this is where it's gonna get a little bit more complicated, because like these are our casters and stuff. All right, mental tasks such as music. Okay, so intelligence is important for Sin. What is senses? Okay. We're also gonna give him speed, because I think this should be initiative. Yeah, I want him to act early so he can play his bard songs and fuck with things. All right, where's music? There is music. Music is important. Eventually, Sin's gonna be using bows. Communication. Oh, God. Yeah, okay. We need a talk. We need a party face. 100 int gives you the magic equivalent of power attack. Oh, that's cool. Hell yeah. Wait, no. My senses speed. All At least these levels go quickly. It's not like a ton of stuff to have to worry about. That'll change once we start getting a bunch of spells and I'm waffling over whether or not I want fireball or ice ball or nuclear blast or whatever. Sin is a smart boy. Okay. Eric, pity. Pity affects the amount of spell power a character gets when gains levels as well as overall stamina. And then what does that do compared to intellect? All forms and schools of magic except divinity. Okay, so fuck that. It says pity, divinity. Yes. Pity! And also speed. Speed, very important. Make wounds for heals. Divine magic, divinity. And I mean, I guess I can put like a point into these. There we go. It is speed. See, we're already getting extra spells. Wonderful. Holy water. Seers unholy creatures of the undead and demonic varieties. See, early on in this, I remember fighting robots. I remember fighting spiders and shit. Bandits. Robots. Moths. So I'm sure that'll probably be useful later, but I don't know if I want it necessarily right now. Guardian angel. Absorbs damage. Ooh, okay, sure, that sounds like it could be useful. It's also more mana for healing. Oh, we also have shit like Divine Trap, though. Thankfully we've got a lot of levels here to tinker with. I want Divine Trap. Because right now, Chunk is going to be trash. That's a boost to the lock and trap skill, increasing target adventuring. Okay, so this says target adventuring. I assume this affects my whole party then. So this will make Chunk better at finding and disarming traps. It's not just like the cleric gets better at it. Because if that's the case, I will actually probably invest in this. Power level automatically calibrated. That's convenient. I think it's party-wide. Nice. All right, cool. Yeah, then we'll grab that. Wow. 0 to 14 spell points. Holy crap. All right, and that's mental magic, so we'll dump a level's worth of points in there. And still we go. Gold Leaf, because she's cranking her PD, she's going to have a shitload of spell points even compared to Rove. I might get... Identify items tempting. Ooh, magic screen. Ooh, armor plate. Is that? Yeah, that's the party one. Hell yes. Oh, I remember early game in 6, armor plate. Once we started getting the party buffs, things got so good. All right, and that's earth magic. So I'll put some points in there. Fine. Divinity. 100 PD gives you a skill that boosts resistances. All right. Not quite as impressive as magical power attack, but I will take it. Does it actually tell you? No. I love this face. This is so good. I think he's supposed to be a priest too, because he's got a collar on, but it doesn't matter because that face is Rove. And he is of course going to be doing fire magic. And do I want to crank? No, I'm just going to focus on his magic skills. Give him water, too. I say, do I want to crank stuff like mythology? But with monsters, I don't care. And with items, we can just cast it to identify. Okay, enchanted blade. Which is, this is divine. Divine, yes, yes, yes. I assume it's divine. There's a cross there. Divine. Fire. Doesn't he have one of those things bishops have, a mitre? He may have at one point. I don't think he does anymore, though. We didn't get to bring more or less any of the really cool items with us into this, sadly. Magic missiles. Is it still a fuck you JOE? Damage on opponents in front of the caster. It's a cone. Hell yeah. Okay. Fine. Fire. Wizardry. I love that they called the mage's casting skill wizardry, because we all know exactly why they called it wizardry. Fireball! Hell yeah! Oh, it begins. I'm already excited. We haven't even started playing the game and I'm already excited. I remember really liking the early game of Wizardry 8 a lot. Like, basically, there's this huge temple we're going to go through to get through the beginning.
It's alive.
That I remember thinking, like, oh, this is a great dungeon crawl, and then you get out of the temple and everything starts scaling with you and it's just miserable. So he's a priest, yes. Oh, the cleric collar, yeah, I have no idea what those are called. Okay, so I mean there's a group of crabs over there we can fight.
We can crush them like worms.
I don't know where we're being attacked from, but okay. One crab. Oh. Aha! Okay, so the way this works, you can see that there's those symbols above it. Those are the colors of the characters that can attack it at this range. So Chunk and Sin can both attack it because they're the only ones in the party with ranged weapons. We have our formation down here. We can adjust our formation. I think you can do it during combat as well. We have a little mini map down here. We can also like move if we want to, but for now, I think I'm just gonna maybe. I'm gonna have to learn how to use it. C? S? No, it wouldn't be S. B. I have no idea what it is to cast a spell. We'll figure it out eventually. Energy Blast.
Taken level 2. Care.
So now you can see Rove has a yellow thing on it because he's casting Death Magic. And I'm just gonna hit this. Now, W is move forward. Oh, Vi is coming in to help us. 100 range. Senses gives you ranged equivalent to power attack. Nice. Alright, we fucked that thing up. It didn't drop anything. And this keeps the wizardry thing. When you kill enemies, they explode gloriously. They've been doing that since 6, and I love it. Okay, so we can come down here. God damn it, that voice for Ayla is just maddening. Now, if I recall correctly, there's a big group of crabs over here, and we also have an item, some sling bullets. One thing I can actually, like, you can change your user interface if you want to have things popped out, but I just prefer this for the increased viewing area. I think, yeah, we can actually get rid of that too. I think that's a little better, just not having anything but this. So these didn't used to have transparent backgrounds. One of the things the mod that the fan patch does is adds transparent backgrounds to the UI elements so that you can kind of have actually a pretty substantial viewport here, which I'm thankful for. I see you over there. Soft shell crab 22. Hi guys. So I'm sorry, but I'm gonna try for a level 2 fireball on you.
Taken care of.
They will burn.
No damage. That's disappointing. Come on, Rove, get him. Rove! Oh, that one moved into the AoE. Rove. 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 Rove! It worries me that they're still in the AoE. I wonder if we're in the AoE of this fireball. No. Oh, the melees are going. Okay. Alright. So everybody's attacking this because it's the only one that's actually in range of the melees, I think.
Too far.
Ah, Chunk's out of range weapons. And it looks like this little hand cannon that Scimitar has doesn't have an ammo limit. That's nice. Is it possible to mod in voices? Yes, but I think you have to replace the ones that are currently in the game.
out of reach.
Rove, it's like literally right there, buddy. We've got a staff.
Out of reach.
Okay, you know what, Rove? You just do you. Gibbed. Tased. Missed. So you can see, like, combat takes a while because we have to wait for enemies and all that. And right now it's not bad, but later in the game we're gonna get into areas where enemies will see us from ridiculous distances away, and it throws you into combat and you have to sit and watch these things in the distance just like slowly waddle along. There's a mod to speed up shit. Yes, I'm running it. I have the fan patch that lets me toggle it to basically whatever I want it to be. It's pretty great. So we have a unidentified battle axe. We have a potion. We have a sling. You know, all right, so this is actually just like an actual legit sling, usable. This looks like just a battle axe. All right. And a cherry bomb, which is a fireball. I'm gonna give that to Rove. These can just sit in here, I guess. The sling I'm actually tempted to give to someone. And maybe give that to Goldleaf. Bulletstones. There we go. And she'll swap between those as needed in combat. Okay, and that looks like everything. All right, I'm gonna save. And I'm gonna check the key bindings really quickly. Let's see. Cast spell M. What is C? C is camp. Okay. How about we make C cast spell, and camp can be unassigned for now. Select PCs. Oh shit, there are actually options to like berserk and shit in combat. I didn't actually know that. Pray. Toggle continuous combat. Probably a bad idea. Okay, do I have anything bound to R? I don't think I do, so in that case, I'll throw camp on R. And is there quick save, quick load? Shift Q. How about F5? Nice and out of the way. F5. Quick saved. Wonderful. A button to breathe. That's for the dragon. The Dracons, they have a breath weapon.
Oh, stay alert. Something be making me right dead nervous.
I'm beginning to regret the choice in voice for Swell, or for Chunk. That is one thing, though, is one thing I actually really like is how talkative your PCs are in this. They have comments on so many fucking things. Okay, so can I be like a bastard? Because there's crabs over there. Can I just be like...
The very hordes of hell could not do it.
Dude, I just want you to throw a fireball. Quit being dramatic. I'm into combat mode. Good God. Because they won't know we're here, so I'm just going to have him attempt to fireball.
Hola Podrida.
Follow me to victory.
That voice for Swell is something special. Oh, man. I'm just going to let him shoot this thing as it approaches us, because if nothing else, they're leveling weapon skills. Ooh, nice. All right, 111 experience. I actually don't know how much we need. Oh, we need many, many experience points. We need like another 10,000. Okay. So for now, I don't give a shit about XP gains. All right, let's see what's in this thing. How much bullshit do you contain, magical sea box? Potion of Dracon Breath. We have character take items, party take items, select all. All right, take this. Okay, so this is just all that's in it. Just some potions. All right. And that goes into the party crap stack. All right, now we're going into a dungeon. Oh, Ela's mythology skill increased. Oh, he's like, apparently Goldleaf identified a slime. So this is the thing. I really like this dungeon, and this dungeon is probably the best dungeon in the entire game. But it starts off really good. Like, they start you off strong. Place.
Don't do anything foolish.
Like, with a nice dungeon crawl, and then you get out into the open world in the fucking squirrel dude city, and it's just a nightmare. There are two of them, one for a new party and another for an imported one. Nice. I was gonna say, this is the introduction, or at least the dungeon that I've always done regardless. Unless you're just talking about, like, the intro video. This thing's chunky. 19 hit points. Cutscene, okay. Oh, that's cool. Hell yeah. You have a feathered cap. Are the squirrels worse than the Danes? No. No, the big factions in this, you have the squirrel guys, you have the Umpani, and you still have the Trang. So what is this thing? Not curse, equipable, plus 2 AC on the head. I guess I will give this to Sin. God, fucking at least Chunk managed to bring all of his ninja gear, I guess. So there are some bosses
Look,
in here.
A creature!
I've done voice acting before in my Japanese animes. That's a good gold looting sound effect, damn. Bundle of arrows. Well, that'll be nice for Sin eventually. You can't get this door open no matter how hard you try. It's securely bolted on the other side. These grates are large enough. I can see. Petulant rage. Frank hasn't washed in months. There's no way to get the clothes off of him. Oh god, like his hair is growing through the clothes. Hello. Oh, this is a nastier slime. This one's noxious. Alright. I wanna check something. Why can't Rove attack with this? Short, stab and wand, bash. Oh, it's because this is extended range, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Okay. So yeah, even though Rove has this staff, I'm used to staves just all having extended range, and apparently the staff he has does not. Get him, Ela. Get him, Chunk. You missed, Chunk. I'm disappointed in you. Ah, that's okay. Scimitar came in with clutch. Oh. Potion of moderate stamina. We're looking okay so far. Books include such exciting tomes as Advanced Pest Management and De-slime Your Home in 3 Easy Steps. Do we have different messages? No. Do I ever have a book? Book of Light. So this, I think, this should be like in the old games where it just teaches you the light spell, yeah. Which I think is fire? I check? Not from here. I'm actually gonna give that to Rove. Rove! Use it. Oh, you can't use it, can you? You ass. It's cleric magic, ain't it? Or he more likely already... Yeah, he already knows it. Okay. Old Leaf. I'm just looking for extra spell points here. There you
Splendid.
Go. Fire spell points increased to 18. I think that's probably her first fire spell, isn't it? Man. That high piety is nuts. Odds Day the 23rd, ran out of pickled bloodvine, ordered more from Arnica. Moon Day the 24th, the prisoner ran out of food again. He's lucky to get any at all, in my opinion. Lord's Day the 25th, all is prepared. We leave today on a great mission. I only wish we did not have to leave the monastery empty. I have the strange feeling I have forgotten something. Old Leaf is good. I remember she, like, in Wizardry VI... She was like meh for a lot of game, and then all of a sudden she was like nutso. Beasties, you say? Is there perhaps a secret door, or are you talking about through here where there's shit out in the water that I don't want to think about? Bookshelf is full of dull financial records. Volumes contain nothing but old bills and receipts. I seem to recall... I remember there being like a secret in one of these rooms. I don't know though. You know, for like buttons and stuff. And who keeps this candle lit?
This way.
Damn it, Hila. Why? Why did you have to inflict Italian Bilbo on my party? I can't even be mad. But I'm so mad.
Come on, you wee beasties. Let's fight.
You tell them it's just like some fucking ants or something, dude. You guys are trying really hard, and I appreciate that. What if I go continuous? What is? Let's see what's going on here. Is this just like auto combat, I assume? Bug shoots swell! The hell you say? Yeah, okay, so continuous, they just all keep on going. I would rather stay in phased combat at this point in time. Alright, party move. We want to run. And I think we just have to end our turn. Yeah, these things are going to be sitting back there just like spitting shit at us. Yeah. Oh, she's stuck. New conditions. Paralyzed. That's great. Thankfully, she comes with us when we run in here to kick the shit out of these little assholes. All right. Everybody, do the vine. So you'll notice that Rove can actually attack right now. And that's because of this spider's position relative to him down here in the radar in the bottom right. So like he can attack this one, but if I want him to attack, say this one,
out of reach,
because it's on the other side of the front row. So the combat system in this game, I think, is actually really cool. It's just a lot. And right now it's not too bad, but that's because we're only fighting like four things at a time. Later on, we'll be fighting far more. And we'll see that once we get out of this monastery and into the Arnica areas.
Much better.
Oh, you're fucked now, buddy.
Take this!
Damn it.
We are victorious!
1500? Okay, that was actually really good XP, and you got some skill ups here as well. Nice. Save. Now, I recall there being a pit in one of these hallways where it's dark, and I figure they probably just expect the players running through like a dumbass, and that's naturally how I fell in it the first time.
This is a one-man job.
Oh, Sin's bored of this guy. I think we've already killed one of these things before. Good hit from Chunk. Miss from Scimitar. Oh, fucker's spraying acid. Okay,
I'm on it.
We'll get in there. Fucking slime took a bite out of me.
Take it
easy. 4,000 spooters. Yeah, exactly. That's basically what it turns into once we get onto the overworld. Oh, Sin just leveled.
How exciting. I think I'm improving.
All right. Hell yeah. Level ups? In my video game? It been hinted by Vidomina, you can end up in a three-way battle between you, the local guards, and the Savant guys. Oh my god, yes, I know exactly what you're talking about, and holy shit, that fight will take you like 30 years if you aggro any of the Savants into any of the defenders in that town. The deadpan voice, I figured it was fitting for Sin. Okay, music. I need to remember to use his musical instruments because we've not been. And that is a crime. So I'm curious. I'm gonna keep leveling his bow. I need to see what his little ray gun uses, if he even has the skill to use it. Let's see. What is this thing? Modern weapon. Okay, so yeah, he doesn't have any skills. Yeah. He's not going to be able to do much with that thing. We'll eventually get him a bow one day. all this crap into here. It's nice that it auto-stacks your things for you. I appreciate that. I want all potions up at the very top. Oh, please tell me these are, like, moderate heal. Oh, God. No. They're the same potion, though, so that's something. Okay, I want him to keep his swords. All right, gotcha. It's like, it's also, yeah, it's a gadgeteer weapon. I wanted Sin to be a gadgeteer, but bards are just great. We have a map, actually. We do, look at that. It's not amazing, but we have a map. That's good enough. Darts. Some feather darts. Ah!
I saw something moving over there.
We've been accosted.
He's a symbol.
Okay, so you can see here the problem. Our back row is facing these guys. So, like, what I could do is move them all down here. But I think what I would rather do is just...
With pleasure.
Move. And that'll fix our... That's the word I'm looking... Where we're facing. You can learn a lot of modern weapons. Maybe that would be nice. If anybody's going to do that, it'll be the Umpani that'll teach us that stuff. Better map than the one from Thunderscape. That's not saying much. I mean, it's a better map than the one from Daggerfall, too. Man, Thunderscape. Thunderscape is a game that I want to play, but I know it's just going to be bad. More receipts. Daggerfall dungeons, yeah. Infinite depth. What the fuck is that? Oh, is that another? That's a poser's cap. Alright, what is this? Plus 10 to locks and traps, curse status unknown. Burglars wouldn't use it. And of course, ninjas can't use it. God damn it. Payroll records for something called the Brotherhood of the Ascension. The map lets you take notes. That's good to know. That will be helpful once we're in town. Mildly ominous. And I can't do a thing with it. All right. You do you, random glowing tapestry. More XP for an abat than many of the mobs from one. Yeah, you ain't kidding. Spaghetti code in 3D. Yeah, the maps from Daggerfall. I kind of get what they were going for. They wanted to make them feel like big fuck huge dungeons, and they did. But the problem was that they didn't know when enough was enough. So you got just go to bed, Lysandus. Now is not your time. We'll be back to Daggerfall one day once I'm allowed to play good games again. A wand. No, oh, fucking knockpicks. Hell yes, he's cast Knock. And also, I think Knockpick is the fucking coolest name in the world for a wand that unlocks things. It's such a cute play on words. I love it. It makes me smile every time I see it. Swap between normal mode and search mode. Oh no. We'll worry about that later. Is this...
There is a lock.
Oh my god!
All set.
It's locked! Esports. The devs had no idea that dungeons need more rooms than hallways. Yeah, exactly.
This will be a beautiful battle.
King Crab, 85 hit points. This is gonna be a fight. Okay. Scimitar. Use. Use.
I'm on
Angel's
it.
Angel's tongue. Get the bless going. Gold leaf. Armor plate, please. Wizard. I desperately want a fireball because I have to fireball, but I think energy blast is probably going to be a little bit better for single target. Okay, and these guys are just gonna sit here and look really pissed. Go Chunk.
Shoot.
God damn it, Scimitar, one job. Wow, 29 damage. That was a hell of a hit with that fucking stun rod. All right, Sin, use Angel's Tongue. And I want you to, I like that it has like a spell memory and it remembers what you last cast.
Taking care of.
So spamming is a little bit easier. Rangers have passive search as a class skill. Nice. If B-Cat's around, he'll appreciate that. Ranger's getting some love. Wow, that wasn't a fight at all. We kicked the shit out of that thing. I guess that's what happens when it's 1-on-6, though. Got a point of pull arm, some fire magic. Hey, buddy, what you got in here? A potion of cure light condition. And some more arrows. Bundle of arrows. At least they're giving us ammo in quantity. Oh, is this? This is where we came in. Oh, look at that! They're doing that thing that Dark Souls does, guys, where they've got the looping around on each other. This game has clearly learned some lessons from FromSoft. The design of Dark Souls is prevalent everywhere. Yeah, I don't think we want to go out there quite yet. Is that another? Just a sling? Hell yeah. Throw that on somebody later. The Dark Souls of RPGs. Oh god. Clearly this is the Dark Souls of RPGs. Alright, what is the hotkey for opening the map? Tab. Okay. You joke, but this game can't. It came out after Kingsfield. Oh shit! BG Noise pulling into lore! I didn't actually know that. Holy shit, I didn't think Kingsfield was that old. I shouldn't say Kingsfield was that old, I didn't realize this came out that late. When did this come out? I assume probably like 2020? This came out in 1994? This came out in 2001. Oh, Kingsfield. Alright, yeah. It blows my mind that Kingsfield came out in 1994. That's... damn. Game's 30 years old right now. Thing's got kids.
Ah, locked.
All set.
This will be a beautiful battle.
Hello, random bugs. I think there's one on the other side of the wall. Man. That's stun rod, no joke. And of course, the Italian came in and killed everything. Potion cure poison. Sure. And flip search mode on. I need to hotkey that. Where is search mode? It needs to be something that I can. It can be X. Something that I can easily just flip on and off. Wait a minute. Wow, that's like some. That's some dungeon master level items blending into the floor right there. Yeah. I had to pay attention to the minimap too, it shows you shit. That's how I even noticed that was there in the first place, because Lord knows I didn't see it. Cheeky shit, yeah. Okay, this is just gonna connect. I don't know why it zoomed out there, but okay. Keep an eye on the floor. Actually, you know what?
Yes.
I'll cast light. How novel. They really love long corridors, yes. How else would you know that it's a big dungeon if the corridors weren't, you know, a marathon to run through? Just think of all the processions. Okay, so that just sits around. Do not feed the Rapox. Okay, so Rapox are like minotaurs. I assume he's probably dead. Yeah. Oh, we got his shoes. You examine the skeleton. Some hungry creatures strip the body to the bone, but the corpse seems to be quite fresh.
Pick it up.